Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul, seal your doom tonight. Spooky, scary skeletons speak with such a screech. You'll shake and shudder in surprise when you hear these
spooky, scary skeletons. I think I've probably heard that song 30 times this week. I wonder why. I've heard it in PE. I've heard it in classrooms. It might have something to do with that fall season. All right. It is Wednesday, October 27th, 2021. Thanks for coming back for the third day of school this week. We have 5 days. So how many days would we have left? We've done three. We've got to get to five. I wonder how many that would be. I guess that's two, huh? Now, we really haven't started today. So I would say that we still have Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. We have 3 days, but we call this the hump. We call this getting over that middle piece, and then the weekend is in sight. And that makes people pretty excited most of the time. All right. I did not update our slide, but I think this is accurate. So I apologize if we do have other guest teachers on campus. I apologize for not putting you on the slide, but as I pulled this up, I realized I didn't update it. But I also looked at our sub list and I don't think I saw anyone new. So welcome back to Miss Yoshoka and anyone else who is helping us out today. Lunch menu, I did get it. I got some help from our friends at SFE, and so I appreciate that. We have pretzel rods with cheese dip and ham and cheese power pack. Now again, I don't have a ham and cheese power pack image that really accurately shows you what you're going to get from ours, but typically they put some kind of nuts and maybe some M&Ms or something like that in that. So just know that ham and cheese will be the main portion, and then there'll be a couple other things as part of that power pack. Hopefully one of those makes you say yum. For our friends who've been carrying their lunch containers, I guess, for lack of, or trays, it's probably a better word. Thank you for doing two hands. If you are heading outside, I'd recommend that you hold the part that we put the milk on the tray closer to you, because that milk, believe it or not, is so much heavier than the rest of the food. But as far as I know, we haven't had too many spills, and I appreciate the people taking the time to do that. For our friends eating in the cafeteria, if you forget to get that milk, just wait till everyone's through the lunch line, and then you can come over and grab your milk. That way we don't have people crossing paths. There's been a couple close calls where someone's coming in to get milk and someone's coming with their tray. And I would certainly, again, hate for someone to have cheese fall on them. So if you forgot your milk, you can always go back to that, to the container and get it. But just if you could do me a favor and wait for our friends who've got their lunch yet, that way we don't have anyone running into each other. That's it. All right. There's that sore. And I guess, again, that A is silent, but we know it's coming. What does that A stand for again? Oh, that's right. Accountable. Nice job. I heard some of you sharing that. And we are showing accountability by doing what this week? What was it? That's right. It's fixing our mistakes. Yesterday, we talked about the power of a sincere apology. And a sincere apology sounds something like this. I'm sorry for, and then explain what you're sorry for. Not just, I'm sorry, but I'm sorry for, you got to make up for, you got to share with that person. I'm sorry for cutting in line. I'm sorry for taking the basketball without permission. You got to let them know what you're sorry for. So that's a great way to fix our mistakes. The next thing I want to do is talk about accountable behavior as it relates to our bodies. And I'm going to talk about that at the end here. I got a couple more slides I got to show, but I want to model it for you guys. And I want to do that not on my little screen right here. You know, that's so tiny. You can only see me right there. I'll do it when I'm on the big screen here. So hopefully I remember to do that. All right. Hey, we have given away some fridges lately. I know that we talked about my friend in third grade, Miss Stessic. I think I shared this one. I can't remember. But now that I'm seeing this picture, I think maybe it's our fourth grade one I forgot to share. So I will pull that picture up and get on here tomorrow. I was able to celebrate another one with a second grader. His name's Kainoa. Congratulations, Kainoa. We appreciate you helping out our school. And again, the whole goal here is to get some money to support our schools so that we can get better and bigger experiences in your classrooms and around the school. And again, if I don't have that fourth grade picture up of EJ, I'm going to try to find that in my camera and get it on here tomorrow. So we have one more fridge to give away, and we have one iPad to give away. I'm going to do that other fridge today, and then we'll do that iPad tomorrow. Yesterday, we had Twisted Tuesday trivia. It was a little bit different. You didn't have to name a song, but you did have to name a staff member who, quite honestly, looked a lot like Principal Snyder. That was some big hair. I love that that person gave us that, because there's lots of times when we have pictures of ourselves from a long time ago, it's maybe a little bit embarrassing because fashion changes and hairstyles change. But I love that our staff member showed courage and said, you know what, this is fun. This will get people to know me a little bit better and put smiles on her face. So I thank you to our, I wanted to thank our staff member for doing that. We did have about six or seven classes correctly identify that person. And that person was Miss Janvan. Miss Janvan helps out in our kindergarten, and she also helps out in our intervention. Thank you, Miss Janvan. And to the classes who won, let's see here, drum roll please. We have Miss Butcher's class. Congratulations, Miss Butcher's class. I think that's your first win this year. And wait, we got one more here. We've got, I think, another first-time winner this year, Mrs. Levin's class. Congratulations to those two classes, Miss Butcher and Miss Levin. Listen up. Your prize is an extra recess. If you would like to set that up with either Mr. B or myself, we will watch them. Or if you just want to do it on your own, you're welcome to do that as well. So if you would like to see if Mr. B or I could help you out, then we'll coordinate schedules. Otherwise, you can take them out when a time that works for you. Congratulations, and we look forward to some more big hair trivia next week. Staff members, if you haven't dug through those picture albums, please do. We'd love to have a lot of different ones in there. I know I got a couple that I can choose from next week, but I don't have a ton. So find those big hair photos, send them in. They don't have to be when you're a kid, as you could see from Miss Janvan's. That was when she was an adult. And it's not about trying to really, I guess, make it hard. Sometimes pictures could maybe even be more recent, and that's okay. The chance here is just to get to know each other a little better and have a little bit of fun. Yesterday, we had our school counselor, Miss M, come on, and she talked to you about bubble breathing. I thought that was an awesome video. Hopefully, you guys tried that. If you haven't, teachers, I'd encourage you to pull that video back up and maybe do some modeling with that, because again, our goal is to give you guys as many strategies as we can so that when those times come, when we are upset or when we are mad, that we have something that we can say, ooh, this can help me find joy again. So teachers, pull that up if you haven't had a chance to do that. And I encourage you guys to work through that and see if it works for you. We have an exciting event happening next Wednesday. You know, the last year and a half have been a little bit crazy around school because we just haven't been able to do some of the things that we normally do, just with all the different mitigation strategies we have in place. But we do have our first event in a long time, and this is one that should feel nice and safe because it's going to be outside. You're going to basically be with your families, and this is called Millennials Reading Under the Stars. I've been told from a millennial historian that this event hasn't taken place in about 14 or 15 years, but we're bringing it back, and I think you're really going to enjoy it. Here's what you're going to need. Bring a blanket, bring a lawn chair, bring some flashlights because it will be a little bit darker outside, and you're just going to sit and read and enjoy with your family. Sometimes we forget about the pure joy that comes from reading a good book and doing it with the people that we love. So we are encouraging you to do that. We are going to be outside, so masks will not be required, but you can wear them if you want. And we are just looking forward to a fun 45 minutes outside. If you wanted to bring your dinner, you're welcome to do that. We're not going to have any dinner here for you, but if your family wanted to pick something up and eat that while you're reading a good book, welcome to do that. So we'll talk a little bit more about that. Maybe we'll have Miss Merrick tell you a little bit more because she is the one setting this up. She's rocking Millennials Reading Under the Stars. All right, that is the end of the slides. And I mentioned that I wanted to get here on the full screen. I want to talk to you about another way to fix our mistakes. This is a big school. Let me see if I can get myself on screen here. This is a big school, and there's lots of people going to and fro, whether it's in the hallways, whether it's outside. We've got a lot of people moving around, and when that happens, sometimes people bump into each other. Now, I'm going to say the majority of the time that I see this happen, it's accidental. It's people just not paying attention or just not in control of their body. But I don't see it as purposeful a whole lot. I see it as just accidents happening when people aren't paying close attention. But much like the cars on the road, we are in charge of our body and we want to make sure that we are using it in a way that's safe. But if you bump into someone, here's what I want you to do. I want you to think of it as automatic as saying bless you when someone sneezes. That's something that you do without even thinking. Someone's, achoo, and you say bless you. You just, most of us have grown up in households where that's how we handle that. And you don't even have to think about it. We want to get this behavior as automatic as that. So if I bump into someone, I'm going to pretend that's you, watch, here I come, and I'm like, oh. I want you to think of two things. Say, I'm so sorry for bumping into you. Are you okay? Try that again. Boom. I'm so sorry I bumped into you. Are you okay? If you say those two things, we have that specific apology, and we check in on them and make sure they're okay, that person's going to walk away knowing that, hey, you didn't mean to do that. So I want you guys to practice that today. I'm sorry for bumping into you. Are you okay? Because I think we're going to have a lot less confusion and a lot less people thinking that there's mean behaviors happening on our campus if we just take care of that behavior. It's going to happen. We know it's going to happen. But let's handle it in a way that makes sure everyone knows it wasn't purposeful, because there's a big difference between bumping into someone on purpose and bumping into someone on accident. I think you can handle it. Thanks for listening in. You guys, soar high and take it away, someone.
For the Pledge of Allegiance, put your right hand over your heart and begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please stand for a moment of silence.